everybody, and happy Monday. It is I, your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe Seabee. And happy Monday, you guys. And Monday is always part of our mechanics of songwriting class that we like to say, what makes a hit song a hit song? What is it about a song that makes you just stop everything you're doing to listen to it? And by the time it's over, you want to hear it again, and you want to hear it again, and again, and just some magic thing that happens to you. Not every song does this to us, right? So, you know, I review songs that come up in Billboard, and there's 100 songs in there, right? You know, the Billboard Top 100. So, I'll listen to, 100 little snippets of choruses, and sometimes just one chorus after another just does nothing for me. Some of them, not all of them, but once in a blue moon you get, I don't even know why that one's famous, but here we go. And then a song will pop up and you'll just take notice and you'll be like, wow. And over the weekend, I'm listening to a lot of music. I just, even when I'm just running errands, I'm going to the store or whatever, I listen in my car. Or even if I'm in my office right here, I'll, listen to new music. Or, whether I'm doing something around the house, I'll just listen to, new releases, new things. Especially, I'll go on YouTube and listen to Billboard, the top 100 of, pop charts, and listen to that. And some things really resonate with me, and then other songs don't. And that's like everybody. You know, just because a song is a hit song, there's a majority of people that really like that song and they want to hear it. But if you were to interview all of America, or even all the world, you'd get a different opinion for every song that's played in the Billboard, And most people just listen because it's programmed on radio stations and they just have a small rotation list. And so you almost become hypnotized by whatever the DJs play, because they're told to play certain songs by, different companies, mostly record companies. Well, anyway, I was listening to a bunch of music on YouTube through Billboard Top 100. And one of the songs that popped up that really did get my attention was a song by a girl named Mimi Webb. And her song is called Dumb Love. Dumb Love, that's the name of the song. And it was released on June 11th, 2021. So it's a new song, very, very new. And I just thought the song was beautiful. The first time I heard it, I just went, wow, who's that? And I had to, because I had my, computer on while I was running around, and I had to, by the time I got in the room, that was over, that snippet. So I had to back up, bring the arm back a little bit to find out who that was and what song that was. So that's what I did. And I found the song, and I looked it up, and then I listened to the lyrics of the song, and I just thought the song was really beautiful. And so I was looking up, all the things about the song. I like to do that. So the song, it's a single release, so it was released as a single. There's not an album for it. Let me see. Mimi Webb wrote the song with Amy Mariello and the track's producers, Johnny Black and Garen Goyikian. Johnny Black is the best known of her collaborators, having produced tracks for the likes of Daughtry and Jesse J, It's My Party, and Mr. Probs, Space for Two. So that's the producers. So we know about the song, and a little bit about the song. And Yeah, I listened to it and I loved it. I loved her melody. I loved the music, the openness of it. I even watched the music video and I liked it too, but I don't always like to watch the music videos because I just, you know, especially when I'm listening to a song, I don't want to get into visuals because I just want to hear the audio and the production and then read the words. So that's why I love lyric videos for these. So what I'm going to do right now, without further ado, is I'm going to play you Mimi Webb's song. This is the song Dumb Love by Mimi Webb. Enjoy.
Tattooed on your skin with a safety pin. You and I, we got so high, kissed like heroin. Where do I begin? We had that young love, we had that dumb love, the kind that cut you up inside. My blood was your love. We had that, you jumped and I'm jumping. Crazy kind of something, that dumb love. We had that young
song. I love her raspiness to her voice and the desperation of her voice when she goes to those high notes. Oh my God, I love that. I mean, I believe her when she sings that. You know, it's like, man, I love her voice. It just sounds battered. And I don't know. There's something about her, you know, sometimes you don't even know why you like a song. And sometimes you don't even know why you don't like a song, you know? But this song, Mimi Webb's Dumb Love, I love the lyrics. I love I love the production. I love everything surrounding her voice, you know, all the instrumentation. Everything was great. I loved the whole thing. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Tomorrow we're going to have our live Zoom class, so we can talk about this song tomorrow in class. All right, guys, that is all the time that we have for tonight. This is your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe Seavey signing off. I love you guys. I miss you all. Be safe, and I'll see you tomorrow live in Zoom class. All right, guys, sleep well. Peace.